lawyers for 600-plus Texas school districts will argue to the Texas Supreme Court that the classroom funding is inadequate and it's unfairly distributed.
And that includes cash-strapped Austin ISD. And after talking with school officials, our Alicia Inns is here to explain what's happening in the day ahead. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. Yeah, if this all sounds familiar to you, it's because it probably is. This is actually the seventh time that schools have come before the Texas Supreme Court. And yep, it's always about the same thing, money and wanting more of it. With no state income tax, the school district relies heavily on property taxes and a Robin Hood system. That's where property wealthy school districts like AISD, they give money back to the state for smaller or poorer districts. Now officials are pushing for change and they want to see school choice and the money to follow the students rather than just the districts.
That the system that we have now is inefficient. And one of the constitutional tests is that the system has to be efficient. If it's not efficient, then it's not constitutional. So the Supreme Court needs to look at the case and see, based on what students, how students are doing right now, whether or not the system is producing results with the money that they're being given.
So arguments start at 9 at the Texas Supreme Court building in Austin. After today, the Texas Supreme Court will go over everything on their own and then come up with a decision a few months from now. We will be inside the courtroom today, so stick with KXAN News tonight at 5 and 6, and of course at KXAN.com for the very latest on the trial. Kate.
All right, Alicia, thanks. And you know, this could be the last school finance trial ever. Starting today, a new law lets the Attorney General appoint a 3-judge panel in certain lawsuits against the state. It would take jurisdiction out of Travis County. Senator Brandon Creighton was behind the bill and says the goal is to give better representation for all parts of the state in cases involving